Hello, I'm Levi Phillips, a senior medical laboratory science student at West Liberty University, and I'm going to show you what it's like to go on a clinical rotation at WVU Medicine, Wheeling Hospital. So now we're in the blood bank, and we have all the blood for patients that could be used for traumas, transfusion therapy, if they need platelets, fresh frozen plasma, blood product. This is where you would go to get it. So this instrument here is the Vision. It does forward and reverse typing on blood. You get A positive and you get the type, antibody panel, antibody identification. So next we're gonna head over to chemistry, where we process most of the samples. We receive our samples right here, and they get all sorted out. And then we can take the sample from here. Most of the time, we'll put them in here to their desired location. And then the instrument will pick it up, and it'll move it along the track, and it'll take it to some of the analyzers over here. So in the chemistry area, we receive samples from in-house, out-of-house patients. And what we do is we can have complete metabolic tests, metabolic panels, electrolytes, you know, just all the basic chemistries that you would get on a routine specimen. Next, we're going to move over to hematology. So now, in hematology, we get a lot of blood smears. When we look at a blood smear, we're looking for white blood cells, red blood cells, red blood cell morphology, white blood cell differentials, so neutrophilic eggs, bands, lymphocytes, monocytes, stuff like that, anything out of the norm. Now we're going to go across the hallway and visit microbiology. So here we have some auger plates. This is blood auger we've grown into a culture. We could take a urine sample and streak this, and then we'll do diagnostic tests on it, and we'll find out what bacteria is growing in that sample. That's a gram-negative rod, probably Klebsiella pneumo. This is the walk-in incubator, and it stays at 37 degrees Celsius, other known as body temperature, because that's what a lot of microorganisms grow at, is body temperature. CO2 incubator, where microorganisms that grow best with CO2 are kept in here and grown in here. This is where the blood cultures are kept, all sequentially. So this is the zero pressure room, or the isolation room. And in here we have the hood. So we, if we're working with bacteria that's airborne or something like that, everything goes in through the vent and not out through the door. So there's only air coming in, not going out. So we'll take our loop, get a little loop full of our sample, and then we'll streak for isolation. We streak for isolation so we can get isolated colonies. We can pull them off there, and we can help, it'll help us identify that bacteria. Thank you for checking out the Medical Laboratory Science program. For more information, go to westliberty.edu/MLS.